Hey y'all, I'm just coming really quick. It's the night before my transfer. I just did my prayer, my devotional reading, my scripture reading, and just an overall praise and just thanked God for this opportunity and this new season.
Hey guys, I'm looking a little rough today, this morning, but I don't care. I'm going to lay on a bed to get prepped, put these embryos back in, so I'm not trying to be all cute just yet. Talk to y'all later.
Really? Go. That was weird. I was like, y'all gonna count?
What's the name of this bridge?
My prayers for God to move in this place.
Voice, you will see that
out of the
Kiss.
Oh, I'm excited.
It's exciting.
It's good. Okay, y'all. So we just got checked for the line. You say the line it was perfect. Oh, and also the eggs fluffed out. They only had to defrost two, and they fluffed out. So I'm excited, y'all. I'm excited. Everything is going perfect. They 100% fluffed out, and they're both still. What you said, 5AA. Both of them are still 5AA, y'all. This is amazing. Come
hello. I'm going to check your ID, okay?
Oh, I'm sorry. All right. I'm looking that way.
And your birthday,
11-2-1982.
I'm sorry, you've got a lot of quinone there. You can't do a job on it. I'm so sorry.
she'll slide it through the one she has in place. Mm-hmm. And then in that sense, air bubble.
Stuck in the elevator. Oh my God, we're stuck in the elevator.
All right, y'all. So I can't video. We'll wait till we get outside. I'm laughing at you. Hey, watch the purse now. Watch the purse. You will be buying me an early push present. Thank you, honey. Open the door for the first day of your pregnant woman's journey.
Yeah, are you good?
Yeah. I was pointing to them, which I can't tell, but they're there. There was two.
I watched them go.
They put them in together. Hubby watched them go in. He was lucky. Lucky dad. Lucky dad. Don't shake.
Oh.
All right, so guys, I'm gonna go ahead and lay back and get comfortable so that way I can enjoy this ride.
Whoa.
All right, guys, I'll be speaking with y'all when I get home. Bye. Love y'all. Thanks for everything. I'm excited, all grand.
What's up?
I want to take my time to let you.
Bro, I guess while we drive, we could talk about my experience up in
Okay. So you want to talk about your experience?
Yeah, so, they let us record, obviously, so y'all get to see the video and everything. She was a trooper. Y'all will see, you know, in the video and everything. I saw the Embers go in. I saw both of them. They went in together, so it was awesome.
I know. The embryos were holding hands.
Yeah. They went in together.
They made the leap.
Yeah. It was awesome, man. And I wore my lucky shirt.
That's a lucky shirt?
Yeah. It's my lucky shirt. But anyway, it was a cool experience, man. They did it real quick and everything, and they explained everything to us as they was doing it. And
you don't know what to say, poor thing.
I don't.
He's lost for words.
I don't.
The Valium is pretty much gone. Like, they didn't give me much. They gave me a shot right here.
Oh, we knew when you got
they
the
took blood. I didn't know they was taking blood. You see him take the blood?
Boy, yeah, she
I didn't know they was taking blood. She was like, okay, it's gonna be a quick, I'm gonna go ahead and give you what you call it. And I was like, okay.
She
took blood.
She did a good job with that.
How you know it hurt it?
I watched. But you know what, though?
What?
We knew when the Valium hit you, you was a whole different person.
I was quiet. I wasn't goofy.
No. Yeah. What?
I was quiet.
You was asking all kind of questions.
I like asking questions.
Your brain was working, though.
If my brain wasn't working, I wouldn't be alive. Now it's time to go home and eat.
Yeah.
And I actually sat there the whole time with my bladder full. I did good. And when I went to the restroom, y'all should have seen how slow I peed because I did not want to push.
Yeah.
So I just she came knocking on the door. She's like, you okay? And I'm like, yeah, just kind of taking it easy. I'm just letting it, you know, go naturally and not, you know, how you go to the restroom, you trying to hurt and push it out so you can go. So I was just letting the urine just come or whatever. So I didn't want to push or anything like that. So I'm excited.
To everybody, I said thank you.
My husband said thank you. What am I saying thank you for?
You know, everybody wishes and stuff. Y'all, you know, support and everything. It's kind of like moms. The support and stuff like that. All the positivity and just everything. Just thank y'all, you know.
So. Yeah, the YouTube watch it.
the YouTube community is wonderful, especially in the IVF, and I'm pretty sure there's other communities out there that support each other depending on what the situation is. And I do want to take the time out to really say thank y'all for, you know, supporting me and my husband, and, you know, sending positive vibes and prayers for those that, you know, were praying for us, and those that were thinking about us, and just the constant wonderful feedback that we get from our videos. You know, I do tend to be able to help, you know, somebody else with these videos, and hopefully, like I told my husband, one day, you know, we get really, really wealthy, I do plan on helping, you know, a lucky lady out one day, you know, because, I mean, we didn't have to pay as much as some people have to pay, but it was more than what we expected to have to, you know, pay out of pocket. But in the end, it's all worth it, and I wouldn't change a thing about the journey. I'm, you know, I do have my 2 weeks before my test, which is the day after Labor Day, and so I'm excited. I'm not sure if I'm gonna test before or not. I don't know. I mean, I'm not going crazy as of now. So I'm not, oh my gosh, I can't wait till I can test. I'm not. I'm just enjoying the moment. I'm enjoying the fact that, as of right now, I'm claiming like I am pregnant. I have, you know, two babies in me right now, and I'm claiming every bit of it that I am pregnant. So,
yeah, but
you
they
know,
they were still grade A.
Yeah, like all of them, both of them were still grade A. Like, how does that happen? You know, like, it's just nothing but God. And I just thank God, though. You know, I thank God so much for this opportunity, this blessing, and the long road that we went through, you know, was to strengthen me and also to make sure that everything was done in the right timing. So, I mean, trust me, I praise God before it happened and during and after, you know, and I just can't wait, you know, to dedicate these children back to Him once they're here, and just to be like, you know, God, I'm giving them back to you. In regards to saying thank you so much for blessing me with them. So we're happy, we're excited, and I just couldn't be happier with the support I've gotten from friends, family, and YouTube community, and all the YouTube aunties, that's what I call y'all. So anyway, just continue to pray for us, and like I said, I know I'm going to be praying for y'all. I prayed for y'all last night. Every night, you know, I pray for the whole IVF YouTube community. So, I feel great. I have no side effects whatsoever. I feel like they're nesting right now. They're finding the perfect spot to nestle into and to get comfy for the next 9 months. And I feel like they're back home. And I think that they're just, like, so attached. Like, oh, my mama, I'm back home. I'm here, you know, and I just know that they're strong too. You know, they're the strong troopers. And, you know, I don't know which two God decided to give to us, you know. It's going to be exciting to see the two, you know. So, just very prayerful and thankful and just happy, you know. I mean, words just can't describe how I feel right now. It's been a long, long road. And like I said, you know, I'll make a video that kind of tells about my long road, because I know some people see that I just started in March with this actual cycle. And it was a long road, you know, beforehand. And it was a lot of down, disappointments, anger, being upset, not knowing, you know, what was going to happen, where it's going to come from. So I can honestly say is when you're not thinking about it, and when you're not, when you stop thinking about it and you just leave it alone, it's exactly when it happens. So I don't know, I'm so happy. So, but I'll go ahead and talk to you guys later. I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of rest a little bit and just kind of chill, get home and try and grub, because I am hungry, and then we'll go from there. Peace. Hey ladies, so I am actually laying down on my couch. I hope you can see me. But I am laying down on my couch, getting me some rest. I think I'm gonna go ahead and take me a nap after I take my medicine. And take my medicine, which is the prednisone and the
estradiol or whatever. And that's pretty much it. I've already put in my the vaginal quinone, the progesterone. So I put that in. I already took one doxycycline, and I only have one left to take for tonight. And then the estrace or the estradiol. On my paperwork, it said take 3 times a day. Now on this new paperwork, it says 2 times. So I don't know. But anyway, we'll see. I'll take the first one. Hopefully the doctor will call me back. Well, they'll call me and let me know how many to take for that. And they got to call me to let me know what my progesterone level is. If for some reason it is low or not where it needs to be, then I'll have to take a mini HCG shot, which is done in the behind. I did ask them for, you know, if there was any other needle where I could do it in the stomach, and they're like, no. So I'm just praying to God that everything is, you know, good. I know the HCG mini dosage is to promote good implantation and pregnancy. So I'm hoping that my progesterone level is really good, so that way I don't have to see another needle until my blood drawn for a pregnancy test. So, hey ladies, so I'm coming to you really quick once again. My doctor just called, and one of the nurses, and they said that my estrogen level or progesterone level, one of the levels, was at a 34, and they like to see it at like a 50. So that's why they tell you sometimes they want you to take like the mini dosage. So I gotta have 2 more freaking injections, one tomorrow in the butt and the other on Saturday in the butt. Like, and I even asked him if there was like a smaller needle, and they was like, nope, you gotta do it in the butt. And she was like, well, it's not as much that you gotta take this time than the first time. And I'm like, it's not the amount, it's the needle. So anyway, I just wanted to update y'all on that part as well. So I will be having to do another injection on tomorrow, and I guess I'm okay with it. I mean, it could be worse. I could be doing the oil progesterone shots. I could be doing, you know, other shots as well, injections rather. And so I'm just gonna take it with a grain of salt and just go for it. So I guess tomorrow, and I know it say it takes about 24 hours before the, about 24 to 36 hours before the egg actually attaches, you know, to the uterine lining or whatever. So I know they probably want me to do it, well, they want me to do it tomorrow anyway, between 4 and 6. It's not really a time constraint as much as the first one or whatever. So they're like, well, get your husband to do it. And I'm like, do you know how hard it was to try and let my husband to do one of the injections? Like, it's not gonna work. I just don't like them, period. It doesn't matter who gives them. I just don't like needles. Like, I don't like them at all. So anyway, that's that. So I just gotta go with the flow and, you know, and just do it. You know, I'm not going to complain about it. You know, thank God that there is something that can help with those levels. I did pray about it and ask God to make sure those levels was high enough, of course, but, you know, maybe he wants, you know, maybe God wants to put more oomph in it to make sure they stick. I don't know, but hey, it is what it is, and I'll take it. As of right now, symptoms that I've been feeling, I'm still a little crampy, which I told her I've been cramping all week. Ever since my trigger shot, I've been cramping. You know, I used to get like that dull feeling in my ovary or whatever, where, you know, I know that one big follicle was. She told me that, you know, if it's more pain, it's not as painful because I don't have to take medicine. Like, it's not as tolerable. But anyway, she said, you know, that it's okay for me to feel a little cramping, you know, because they're trying to find a spot to bury into. So it's a lot of, you know, it's a little, little movement, little stuff down there. And then she says that I may have like maybe a little spotting or whatever from just them actually going in. You know, it could have, the little catheter thingy could have scraped, you know, anything could have happened. So she was like, just make sure you look out for it. If it happens, then, you know, that's fine or whatever. Don't freak out. And I also asked her, could I use my heating pad, because I am a heat pad fanatic. Like, I love my heating pad. Like, you know, when I'm cramping, like, that's like my comfort thing, and it just works so well, the littlest heat. So she told me, no, I cannot use my heating pad. And my husband will be so happy to hear that, because he's like, he hates when I use the heating pad, you know, for whatever reason. Pregnancy symptoms that I'm feeling, no, I'm kidding. And I'll talk with y'all, I guess, maybe tomorrow, after maybe I give my shot or before, I don't know, like, unless I have anything that changes progressively, then I probably won't come back on. The next time I come on, it may be around the 2 week, you know, the end of the 2 weeks, because, I mean, there's not nothing else to say other than, you know, if I have any symptoms, if I have any symptoms by the end of the week, it's lightning and thundering. Lord, that's some good sleep, huh? Just took a little nap, as a matter of fact. But, yeah, so I may start having symptoms after this week. I don't know. So it depends. If I start having symptoms or if anything happens, I'll come back on and update y'all. But other than that, I'm going to go ahead and eat, take this medication. Morton is still on, but it's just getting kind of tedious, so I'm probably going to turn and probably watch a movie or something like that, because it's raining, it's thundering, it's about to storm. Perfect weather to take another nap and to make sure that my babies are getting all of the energy, you know, all that good rest, you know, to help them grow. So, peace. Talk to y'all later. Bye.